Are we ready?
We good, Ivan?
Yes, good.
Did you give him one?
Yeah, he has.
Okay, so everyone's ready, right, okay. So, welcome to the JTA, thank you for coming out today. Thank you for being so flexible in your scheduling too, we appreciate it. You have 20 minutes for presentation, 20 minutes for question and answer. I will keep charge, keep track of the time, so I'll let you know when you're getting close, okay? But we are videoing it as per statute. This is a public meeting and we need to provide either a recording of the meeting or minutes. We elect to do a video recording. So Teresa, why don't you go ahead and start?
I will start us off. We are here today for JTA solicitation number P16021 for bus stop cleaning and maintenance. Today we have Professional Maintenance of Florida presenting. I am Teresa Lind, JTA Contracts and Procurement Manager.
Jackie Glass, Senior Manager, Contracts, Procurement, Inventory.
Joshua Gray, Transit Amenities Coordinator, JTA.
Ivan Mitchell, JTA Planning.
Van Dyke Walker, Facilities Manager.
I'm Randy Bruin, Senior Manager of Maintenance.
Just one clarification, your evaluation team consists of Randy, Ivan, and Josh, okay?
Very good.
My name's Anthony Molino, I'm VP of Business Development, Professional Maintenance.
My name is Henry Hammer, I'm a CEO, President of Professional Maintenance of Florida.
Go ahead and start here.
So I will start the clock and we're ready.
Let me first again thank you all for the opportunity to present. Again, my name is Henry Hammer, the President and CEO of Professional Maintenance of Florida. We are here today to present ourselves and to let you know what we do and how we do it and what we've done in terms of planning this program. The first slide that you'll see up here is about us. Is essentially will cover a great deal of us. Our business is here in Jacksonville. We accept for one account, which is in Palm Coast, 99.9% of our business is here in Jacksonville. We've been in business for over 9 years, approaching 10. Well, we have over 40 years of experience in cleaning and detail cleaning. Currently, we service over 1 million square feet of commercial space on a daily basis. All of our employment is internal. That means that we do not subcontract our work. These are our employees that come to work for us every day. We have extensive industry knowledge. The ultimate thing for us is to be able to deliver a really concise package. We use corporate vehicle insurance, which gives us and you the additional coverage should an incident happen, that we give you that protection. We have a solid management team. This is just not with Anthony and myself, but the other people that are involved in our company who stand with us every day, helping us to make sure that we're efficient. Our experience is highly efficient. Today, I'd like to say that we're closer to an efficiency company because of what we do. We look at each project, each program, and break it down into small, individual, bite-sized pieces. This way, as we learn through the communication and feedback that we get from our customer, the end user, the ultimate end user many times. For us, this might be an office building or some of the people within your building operations here, so that we can improve and develop, make it better and more efficient. It's a turnkey management system that we bring. We're able to plug and play, literally. We are a green cleaning company. I'm sorry, but our focus is not as much on the environment as it is on our employees and the people we come in contact with every single day. Our employees mean more to us. Although we do provide them with personal protection equipment and supplies, green cleaning is using chemicals that are safe for the people that will come in contact with them. We have multiple business verticals so that we learn from each of the different types of projects that we're involved in. It allows us the flexibility as a boutique cleaning company to bring our systems to play and make ourselves much more successful. We have all of the required resources to step in, as I said earlier, to do a turnkey management system. We have a very low turnover rate with our employees and our customers. We actually have some part-time employees that have been working for us for more than 8.5 years. These are part-time employees. We take care of them. It's critical because we know that they deliver,
You'll be happy.
My name is Anthony Molino. First of all, I'd like to say thank you, as Henry said, for giving us this opportunity to present to you today. We're happy to say we are currently a partner of the JTA. We perform janitorial services on your main campus, as well as some outlying buildings for you. We feel the brand recognition of being an affiliate of the JTA elevates our business as well as motivates us daily. So we look forward to growing with you over the years to come. On the title slide, you saw Rogers Cleaning Service. Thanks to Ken Middleton and the JTA DBE program, we were able to actually develop a really strong relationship with Chris Rogers and Rogers Cleaning Service. After many discussions and bid submissions, we've learned that he has actually all the available equipment and supplies necessary to be an effective partner on this project. Just some facts about his business. I won't rattle down the road too far, but I guess the most important parts there are his foundation and workforce. He is also a turnkey management figure in this project.
And was recommended highly by Ken Middleton, and thank God, because he's really come through for us. As you can see, some available equipment. I won't rattle down the row, but the most important thing there is the two hot water pressure washers. That's going to come into play in this project for us. This is a developed list of essential personnel as we see it in order to be effective in this project. I think the most important person and the key manager of this project will be the bus stop maintenance coordinator. This is a full-time hired and vetted employee of ours that will be dedicated solely to this account, 100%. He is in charge of coordinating all the employees on the routes determined by him and the transit amenities coordinator. He intercepts all calls from employees, manages all reporting to JTA, acts as a direct point of contact from us to you, and also is available 24/7 for all emergency calls as well as follow-up to those calls. He is reporting directly to Henry and I, so we are always involved. It's not just him running the project. The next person down the chain of command will be the quality assurance representative. This is also a full-time employee, available 24/7. This person will follow the routes of the ground crews on a counter-cyclical schedule to review the work that is completed Monday through Friday. This person is, as I said, a full-time employee, will always be available. He will report directly to the maintenance coordinator and to Henry and I, and will also be required to report any external issues pertaining to JTA assets, meaning if a grounds crew by any chance misses an issue with a piece of glass on a bus stop, that person will then report that the next day to the maintenance coordinator, who will then be reporting that to the proper authorities by the transit amenities coordinator. Moving down the list, the grounds crews are the boots on the ground conducting the work. They complete the work on schedule and accordance to the transit amenities coordinator standards as well as JTA standards. They will adhere to strict safety standards as outlined in our safety manual, which we provided in the bid package. They'll work Monday through Friday, 8-hour noctivagant schedule. They'll work through the night as to not disrupt bus scheduling. And they will report directly to the maintenance coordinator and be guided by Henry and myself also. And then you can see our DBE partner, if and when we're awarded this contract, they will be awarded 25% of it and paid in accordance to JTA DBE program standards. He will also be reporting directly to the maintenance coordinator and will be handling all the downtown locations as well as the pressure washing schedule.
In the essential personnel from our company, myself, as the president of the company, I'm intimately involved in our operational protocol. It's our lifeblood. This is our DNA that we're putting forward to you. We guarantee and deliver. We have a strategic vision and a plan, and we'll make recommendations to change that process so that we can deliver the utmost of success. We work closely with the amenities coordinator and to ensure our quality. where I am directly involved in the hiring of all of our employees. We do an extensive background check on our employees as well as an interview process. And then a training process that happens. On our normal cycles of hiring our employees, we'll put them to work in a place for up to a week's period of time, depending upon the profile of the account and the required. And then they will be shifted into a working place, not hired and put on the job that day. Anthony's position is Vice President of Operations. He works directly, again, with our maintenance maintenance coordinator and the transit amenities coordinator and myself. He'll be reviewing and approves all the reports that will go to JTA. Involved in the hiring process as well, we want to know our employees and make sure that we've got everything done properly. We'll initiate and manage our strategic vision as we see it and as it develops.
All right, this is an operational flowchart of the chain of command as we see it. This is subject to change after speaking with the transit amenities coordinator. It looks a little prettier on my computer. Sorry. As you can see at the top, transit amenities coordinator as well as the PM executive team are in direct communication with each other and also with the bus stop maintenance coordinator. Bus stop maintenance coordinator is the key figure in this project. He's running everything for us. He's 24/7 availability. He's in charge of employee management as well as quality assurance in scheduling and follow through and execution as well as paperwork flow to JTA. The next person down, as we've already discussed, is the quality assurance representative who reviews and reports all work completed by grounds crews, the DBE partner, and anyone else involved. And this is the workflow as we see it now. This is also subject to change once starting the project. But this, please keep in mind, does not encompass the work the DBE will be completing downtown. This is as we see the work being broken down with our teams in the evening. We have Group 1 and Group 2 bus stops. Group 1 consists of 470 stops that consist of once a week cleaning. Group 2, it consists of 64 stops that require three times a week cleaning. These two groups will be combined and then divvied out to two teams that will work noctivagant schedules, 8 hours a day. Monday, Wednesday, Friday, they will be required to complete either 57 or 58 stops, depending on the week. And on Tuesday, Thursday, we'll be required to complete 47 stops. This will ensure all work is completed on a timely schedule within requirements for the project.
And the difference between these two numbers of stops are the size of the stops and the location. This way we can be efficient, put the proper amount of time in each one of the locations in terms of our cleaning.
And also you'll see in the corner the pressure washer, real quick, 661 sites per quarter, which breaks down to approximately 11 sites per day, 5 days a week.
We've built a transition schedule. From the date of the award, job positions and training will begin. The maintenance coordinator will be appointed and begin his or her training. The DBE's schedules will be defined and refined. We'll acquire all of our supplies, make sure that our equipment and training is up to speed. The next step from there, it will be meeting with the amenities coordinator, determine the most efficient routes, and
GIS application.
Yeah, GIS training. Application, I'm sorry. Making sure that it's up and functioning and well put to place. The maintenance coordinator's paperwork training will take place. Paperwork and submission and the training and schedules will be there. The mock routes will be scheduled. After that, we will run mock routes.
We'd like to be as efficient as possible upon launch, so mock routes would be a great way of ensuring that when we do start, everything goes smoothly the first night. We can hop right in.
Yes. Employees and equipment will be readied. Final adjustments with the amenities coordinator, and then the work start date will be established, and then, bam, we start. We will be ready. In terms of our supplies and equipment, we'll be using hot water pressure washer to take care of hazardous spills or issues that come up, as well as also for emergency calls, including structural and grounds cleaning. We'll be using rear tow utility trailers for help with moving lawn and maintenance equipment, as well as also trash removal. Additionally, we'll be using Ford Transit vans, which will be clearly marked so that they can be identified that is who is here, including the pickup trucks, all clearly marked and specific to the job so that they are identified and ready to rock and roll. And in terms of the equipment and supplies, each vehicle and management person will have metal and plastic scrapers, high density plastic bags, 22 micron bolt cutters, should they be necessary, heavy duty scrapers, safety equipment, including yellow vests, work gloves, protective eyewear, face masks, where or if necessary, as well as face shields. Additionally, there'll be Toro lawn equipment, a smattering of another brand in there as well, currently that we own, as well as for the grounds maintenance, weed eaters, lawn mowers, and backpack blowers. Our cleaning supplies, again, are as green as possible. The one exception there would be the glass cleaner and the graffiti removal. They sometimes, to be effective, are not green. Today, glass cleaner is not a green product in terms of the items that we use, just from our personal satisfaction and success.
In summation, Henry and I developed this statement, and we intend on living by this once awarded the contract. Our goal is to provide the Jacksonville Transit Authority with a superior service, providing you with cost savings and the peace of mind that the end user is enjoying a safe and clean environment.
This is truly the key to our foundation and the success. We modify what might be a proposed scope of services as we find things will be better delivered by a slight upshift or change. We'll coordinate that so that it is explain it and then deliver it. Again, providing the best possible service and savings that we can deliver.
And now we'll open it up to questions.
Can I start?
Sure.
A lot of the experience that I've seen in your package is related to doing maintenance and cleaning on a larger scale property. What types of issues do you see with doing a lot of 300 plus stops across a large geographic area, and how do you plan on overcoming those challenges?
Well, it's actually not much different than taking care of a multi-story office building. It's a repetitive piece of work, emptying the trash, making sure that certain things are done. We have specific jobs for specific individuals. If I was to use a parallel comparison, when we put people into an office environment or a building environment, there are people that have specific jobs. That is their designated job. They're trained and understand it. So that if there is, as an example, someone, this is their specialty, their particular part of the job. This way we can make sure that they understand what they're supposed to do, and that we can make sure that it's done efficiently and that it's done properly.
I feel like it's most important to have appropriate management personnel in place that can drive the crews to be the most efficient they can be. So hiring and training the right people and putting them in the right place is how we will be successful in this project.
That has been our success.
Yeah, it's the personnel that we hire and how they're managed from the top. Henry and I are involved intimately in everything that we do, and they know that. So they tend to work harder for us, and we treat them well. So
yes, we do.
Yeah,
gives us that advantage.
Can you describe in detail the process you use for quality control? I know you guys kind of touched on it, but could you elaborate more?
So as the maintenance coordinator is running the show under Henry and I, the next day a quality assurance rep goes out in a company vehicle and runs those same routes and checks the work that's completed.
That's on a daily basis, every day of the week.
And then reports back to the maintenance coordinator, and then adjustments are made upon the discoveries the quality assurance person makes.
So you're saying basically every stop that they touched the previous night, somebody's going to come and look after it?
Yes,
that is correct.
that's the only way we see our work being double checked and being
and successful.
Yes, I mean that's really the only way to do it, because otherwise
it's all, you know, supervision.
Even with the GIS application, there could still be issues in them showing up, doing what they need to do, but then skipping a few steps to get out of there quicker. And that's what we want. That's what we're aiming to avoid with this person on the staff.
Yes, as this,
and it's an investment that needs to be made in this project.
There's no doubt.
For sure.
The quality assurance person that's going through doing this is probably the second most important person on the project, because they're going to be able to go through and maybe be able to see things that we need to report to you.
Yeah.
That have maybe issues that would come up that would have an effect on the transportation of the and or the location itself. This way, letting you know that there's a lighting that's out that hadn't been reported properly, that there's something that's damaged or broken, and or calling out an emergency service where required.
It's a fresh set of eyes. Definitely. That will help.
How do you anticipate, let's say that person finds something, what is your recommended solution for getting that resolved? Is it an immediate resolution, or
it's
how quickly
immediate
are you
gonna, that day?
That moment, again,
the crew,
that quality assurance individual is gonna have tools with him in the vehicle as he's moving. So he'll comes along and he sees that something wasn't cleaned properly, he'll be able to attack that particular issue, as well as reporting back to our staff, letting us know what was discovered and what was handled. If it's overwhelming,
if it's a piece of broken glass or something that needs to be reported to you, then it's reported to you guys, and then you guys do your thing on that. But he is equipped with the equipment that needs to be available to him.
Are you guys willing to negotiate pricing?
If you feel it's necessary and we can come together on this, I don't have a problem at all sitting down and trying to, again, fine line, cut the little details in place. We recognize the most important thing is satisfaction. If we can't satisfy you, you don't need us. So we want to be able to be there for you and help define and refine the program that we put in place. We've done a serious amount of analysis of how to put this together, but because you folks have dealt with it for all this time, you're certainly going to have insight that we are going to enjoy and be able to use.
We spent a good amount of hours thinking about this one for sure, and are definitely open for discussion on any issue.
Actually,
the guidance from anybody is great.
An example is here on your campus, where we felt you were short-staffed. We've increased the hours of our employees in certain times as to make sure that there is not the crazy issues that might have come up, providing a smooth transition from when we finish at night to when you're full-staffed during the day. This is something that we work on. We realize what's going on. You tell us the issues that are happening, and we'll cut and fit those things into place so that we are successful for you.
That includes pricing also.
Okay. Thank
you. Mm-hmm. Are there any other projects or work that you guys are doing that could potentially distract your team from the responsibilities that are involved with
no,
this
sir.
Program?
And that's why I'm focused so heavily on personnel and putting the right people in the right places. We're running a business, so there are also other things going on at the same time. But as long as we have the right people in the right places, everything will be smooth, especially with the people that we're going to dedicate solely to this account.
That's their
full-time employees only working on this account.
That's the key, is dedicated staff to the project.
Yeah.
It is a 20, the people that will be there will be, this is the only thing that they'll be involved in.
If you think about it this way, it's another arm of our company. It's almost a separate company that will be doing this work for you.
How will you ensure that your crew is provided with the necessary equipment and trained properly for the electronic record keeping?
That will be discussed with the transit amenities coordinator as well as the maintenance coordinator, who then will train all employees on that
in our office.
Each of the vehicles will have GPS tracking devices. And the phones that are be in those vehicles that will be handled by those individuals have got that tracking capability. And we've already implemented similar systems and had them work for us, where our employees are clocking in and out of specific job sites so that we know that they're there, that they spend a proper amount of time, and that, again, quality assurance individual coming back in is going to have those supplies. In terms of answering your supply issue, we deal with supplies on a daily basis and have set target times and places to deliver supplies to our staff.
It becomes pretty pretty routine after, you know, the first month. We always overstock in the beginning to make sure nothing runs out. To answer the GIS application question, in the mock runs, when we start mock scheduling, that will be used in the mock run. So we'll iron out any kind of issues that would come about during that time. So when we start the actual work and the project, there won't be any issues with the knowledge of how to operate the application. I can't tell you if the application breaks down or something. Like, you know,
again,
can't do much about that. But
the opportunity to be able to use the GPS tracking device from both a cell phone capability as well as the vehicle specifically, we're crossing our lines twice to make sure that we're on target.
We're pretty stoked on using that. Actually, I think that's going to be a great thing to use. And if we do end up using it and it works wonders here, we might implement it on the whole. Around our whole company, that's a very efficient way of running it. So
there will be many instances where the frequency of servicing a particular stop may need to be adjusted. What process will you use for effectively communicating those changes to your crews and ensuring that they have the most up-to-date information and cleaning schedules?
The maintenance coordinator will. With the transit amenities coordinator's guidance, will develop schedules. And if there are any changes to those schedules, the appropriate team will get those changes prior to the week of implementation or the day of implementation of that schedule.
No
so
different.
They will know.
Correct. And no different from our regular business. There are certain things that we know that this is done on a certain time frame, and then there's the, I don't want to say odd out, but the unusual situation where it needs to be done on a higher frequency to be able to keep it up to speed and to meet the success and the satisfaction. That's an easy plug-in and make it move forward. Again, the quality assurance individual is right on that.
Yeah. It's just the management, the leader or the key manager is responsible for implementing schedule changes and also ensuring the execution of the schedule.
So. A problem that a lot of our contractors have while out at the bus stops is dealing with some unruly people and disgruntled passengers. What advice would you give your team in dealing with those kinds of people, and how will you be prepared to deal with them?
This, again, similar to our regular business, where it's staffing when there are typically not people on site. When we have that interaction, they are, as part of our training, told and trained repeatedly on politeness, calmness, back away, don't get involved in a confrontation, and simply call it in. Call it in immediately.
Call us.
There's an issue at this location,
to
this
leave
is what's
if
going
they feel
on.
Physically threatened. They will leave, and then we will deal with the appropriate authorities. JTA will be contacted at that point also.
We've had issues where our employees, because of fights breaking out literally in the front of building, have called called JSO and said, hey, listen, we can't go any further. There's something here that needs to be contended with.
If it's a homeless person that's sleeping on the bench, we may just quietly ask them, we have to clean this bench. Do you mind moving? And depending on their response, that's, you know.
If there's a response.
Yeah, if they're conscious enough to respond.
Emergency response is a very important component of this contract. How will you ensure that an issue has been resolved within the 4-hour deadline?
Well, there'll be two people that will be contacted during an emergency situation. It will be myself as well as the maintenance coordinator. The maintenance coordinator, as I said earlier, is a 24/7 employee. They will be responsible for coordinating that work within a 4-hour response time. I will be notified at the same time so I can monitor the situation as well as make sure it's being dealt with in a timely manner. So it's not just going to be an employee of ours being contacted at night, it'll be also be myself.
Additionally, our quality assurance individual is going to be there for those emergencies to follow up.
We're on call 24/7 already. I get calls in the morning at 3 a.m. sometimes.
Okay, so you not anticipate having people, available.
Absolutely, yes.
We already deal with that.
4-hour
kind of
window
now.
Is like superlative.
Yeah, if we sleep 4 hours, it's good.
It's superlative because we got a call at 3 o'clock in the morning and we've got our crew out, we're automatically sending those messages out to them electronically, as well as then making sure that the QA individual follows up on that as a priority issue.
You guys did a great job in your presentation talking about the safety equipment and the training that you provide your crews. Anything you guys want to add to that?
Well, we do go through a significant amount of training with our staff. Yeah. But we talk about personal protection. There have been many occasions where we've walked onto a job site and we provide uniforms specific to our team so that they are safe, first from a clothing standpoint. But we'll many times find our staff will say, well, I don't really like to wear rubber gloves. We bring them in, retrain. This is important.
Requirement.
It's a requirement for us to make sure you're safe. Again, earlier I said that we are a green cleaning company, and that is paramount to us, but it's really our employees that we're concerned about. It's the over the tailgate contact point that the end user gets. So again, we're using things that are as safe as possible, and the training of those people to make sure that they're following the procedures and the things that we do.
If there's anything that sends a red flag out in terms of not being able to operate equipment properly, we're out there. And we usually take about 3 days at that time to first day training, second day monitoring, third day monitoring.
Can I skip you real quick?
No. Yeah.
Just so that we don't run out of time. The total number of trucks, the total number of crews, I know you talked about the DVE, they have 3 trucks, and you guys have 3 trucks?
That is correct.
Yeah. The total is 6 working trucks?
6 working trucks and a car.
QA.
Just for that.
Correct. So the way we see it breaking down, and this is subject to change, so the DBE has 3 working trucks. They'll be required to use those trucks to tow hot water pressure washers as well as dealing with the 2 times a day downtown locations.
They'll do downtowns a day, Monday through Friday.
Correct.
Yes, sir.
Correct. And then we will then adjust the amount of trucks that we have on the road based upon the most effective route. So if we need 3 trucks on the road a night, we'll adjust it. If we can not get away with, but be most efficient with 2 trucks and 2 people per truck on routes to get the required bus stops per week on what's required in the bid finished each week, then we'll adjust accordingly based upon the routes that we determine, predetermine.
And again, the QA person is going to be in a car equipped with enough supplies to be able to do things.
To be effective
that
on the
can
spot.
Be effective as well.
He's not going to be carrying around a weed whacker in his Prius, but.
And then where does the power washer fit? Is it just the DBE downtown?
It's the DBE. He'll have the downtown 2 times a day. That's one set of his responsibilities. Right. And then the other set is a nighttime pressure washer. That's on a schedule that is scheduled to complete 10 to 11 stops per night.
During season.
In order to stay on target with the 661 stops that require quarterly service.
Okay.
So
there'll be additional
facets to his job.
There'll be an additional pressure washer in one of our vans, which will be a smaller unit, really just for those emergency issues where we can't coordinate fast enough.
Very good. Thank you.
All right, I'm going to skip this question here to the last one so we don't miss this. In the event of inclement weather, hurricanes, bad thunderstorms, any staff emergency time off, what procedures will you guys have in place to ensure that any missed work
is? That's a great question. Yeah. And for that reason, because we are a boots on the ground company, we have the capability to mobilize part of our other staff to make sure that those things are picked up, and we'll have that make that happen.
We have a roving supervisor currently who is equipped with the same equipment that could go back and
help build up routes. Let's say if we were having a hurricane moment, obviously that's going to take precedence. Things will shut down during those emergency times. We will back up and then bring our team out in force, as well as adding to that team to make sure that we get caught up quickly. Because obviously you're going to want to put your equipment back out on the street as quickly as possible after an event like that, and we'll be there hopefully ahead of you so that it's not an issue where your ridership is left there trying to go, what's going on here? There are always going to be those odd out moments. But I'm faithful. I'm completely comfortable and faithful to the fact that we'll be able to pull this off.
Not that it's a heist.
All right.
We're not robbing a bank, I promise.
Yeah, I got this one. I think I'm good. You guys have anything else? I'm good.
Okay. Do you have anything else for us? You have about 4 minutes.
Well, just thank you so much for allowing us to presentate to you today. Thank you so much. We really appreciate it. We love working with the JTA right now. We feel like you guys are a great partner. You guys see me enough in your office probably that you get sick of me. I'm running around. I think that's about it for us also. We really appreciate it again.
All right, thank you guys.
Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Does anyone need a card? Our card?
I don't.
No?
Business card?